One of the things that I've noticed, and this is especially true with a lot of tech startups, is that the founders are typically either techies or they're domain experts and all that. And they've worked with large companies and they've worked with cutting edge technologies and all that. But they never sold anything, or they have never kind of had to worry about how this amazing product that I'm going to make, who will sell it? Because in a large company, there are different things. And then you do a startup and then, hey, just creating this amazing product is not enough. You have to go and sell it also. And as the adage goes, the beauty is in the eye of the beholder, right? That's something like that. So, and when I see these tech startups, they look at everything from a tech perspective. And they're so excited about tech. You know what? This has blockchain. I'm like, okay. This has artificial intelligence and this, you know, big data and this thing. See, technology for the sake of technology doesn't mean anything. End of the day, what means is as simple as that. To your intended customer, either it has to save money or it has to make money. End of the day, it's money, right? And so these guys have to look at it not from a tech perspective, because if they look at it from tech perspective, like for example, one of the startup that we are working with, which is there in my accelerator, they are into sales forecasting. AI-based sales forecasting and demand planning. And initially they were focusing on large FMCG players. But when they went to the large FMCG players, these guys were using a lot of other sophisticated tools and all that. For them, you are not that important. And when we started working, I said, you know, the Unilevers or these big guys have all the tools that they want, but what about the sellers on the marketplaces? These sellers are typically, you know, two, three friends get together and say, hey, you know what, let's start selling mobile covers. You know, we'll import it from China and we'll sell it. Somebody likes to make clothes, they will start selling clothes or whatever, right? They do not have access to any of this thing. So for them, if you're providing this service, it was the same software. But for a large FMCG company or a Flipkart or something, it was of no value at all. But when we took the same software to this marketplace supplier, they were like, wow. Because if I am a marketplace supplier, I'm selling on Flipkart, I'm selling on Amazon, I'm selling on Paytm. If I'm cosmetics, I'm also selling on Nykaa. And I think there are 50 or 60 marketplaces, you know. And now Amazon is, now Alibaba is getting active. And now they are talking about that Indian suppliers, if they go through Alibaba and Amazon, will be able to sell worldwide. Now imagine, I'm a small guy, and there could be a situation that I have stocks lying idle in, say, Amazon, but Flipkart is out of stock. And for me, sometimes the margin in that product is not enough. If I have to transport the good once again, maybe my margin will vanish. So for them, it was like lifesaver. They said, oh, and this is an AI-based sales forecasting tool. So it looks at your data, and after a couple of weeks, get into almost like 99% accuracy. And then it tells you, okay, Flipkart, this SKU, this many units, this SKU, this many units. So it does the entire planning for them. And they are like lapping it up. So my point is that don't look at it from a technology perspective. And never say that, you know, oh, our technology is so simple and easy that anybody can use it. Because trust me, if it's everybody can use it, nobody will use it. And you have to start with a very focus. Now, how do you find that focused customer? Every company has a certain core activity. Let's look at, say, Tata Steel. The core activity of Tata Steel is to make steel. And then there are other activities that support the core activity. And then there's a third layer of activities which are nice to have. So the core will be like your supply of your machinery that in the production line. You can't afford to not buy that. So if you are selling machinery which can reduce their production time by X percent, they will listen to you. And then, for example, the supporting thing is the third ring is let's do communication skills training for people. If they don't have the budget, if they cut communication skill down, the company will not shut down. I have been in e-learning for about 12 years. I was running that e-learning company. And one thing, if I can take away from that startup, is never do business which doesn't doesn't satisfy the core requirement of the customer. You could have a technology and all that, which can be used by a lot of it. In that case, you have to go and find that customer for whom the customer should say, wow, where have you been till now? And she should practically get up and give you a hug. And then trust me, if it touches the core and it is helping him save money or make money, you don't have to do the sales call. They will be calling you up and saying, hey, when are you coming to do the demo? When can we install it? When can we do something like that? And I think that is one of the key things, that look at it not from the tech perspective, but from the business use case perspective. And this business use case, is it part of the core activity of the company or not? So I think that if a lot of startups understand, trust me, they can very fast get revenues. They can charge more for the same product. You know, they can charge a premium from the same product. And because now they're specialized in that, their valuation will also go up. It's easier to raise money and everything gets much better because there's stickiness now, you know. I think that's one thing that I see a lot of. I don't blame them. They are first time entrepreneurs. I had no clue of this before I did e-learning, because if I had a clue, I wouldn't have done e-learning. But after I did e-learning, then I realized it's not. And I said, okay, maybe that's something that I've learned that I can pass on. And I hope it's useful.